Friday, WCLU saying good morning to our noted historian, Mr. Sam Terry, as we enter into the archives. Hey, Sam.
Hello. How are you today, Henry?
I'm good. You all right?
I certainly am.
We've had a festive week. We've learned a lot about ourselves. Picked out a few puzzle pieces, and I think Friday we might do the same thing, if you want to go back in time with me here.
Absolutely.
One century back, looking at the various publications that are housed or harbored over at the South Central Kentucky Cultural Center. And we roll back 100 years, a century ago. This was the day that the Glasgow Times reported May Dillingham, Jewel Davidson, Lacey Dillingham, Robert Button, Maud Moore, Thurston Houchins, Henry Earl Hoover, Virginia Redford, and Henry Travis Page made the September honor roll of the Rocky Hill School, where Flona D. Ritchie is the teacher. Now, all the years we've reported one-room schools, that's a really long honor roll to come
from a small
school, isn't it? That was out at, where did I say that was?
Rocky Hill.
Rocky Hill, okay, yes.
Diligent
smart folks, that's right, indeed. Let's flip over here to 1934. We're going to find out some news in the Glasgow Republican about 1934, if I can get the page turned here. Another creative story here in the Glasgow Republican. Your home needs falling airplane protection. For a few cents extra, we can include your fire policy, in your fire policy, coverage against loss from falling airplanes, explosions, riots, and civil commotion, and runaway motor vehicles. Call, write, or phone us at Pettigo Rogers Company in the Trigg Theater building.
How about that?
Of course, this is 1934. Machines weren't all that of a established condition around here. Airplanes, not even as new as that. So I guess somebody creative in the insurance company said, we need to insure these people against, riots seems like an interesting thing to want to be insured against.
Riots or airplanes just falling
just
out of the sky.
That's right. That's right. Of course, they hadn't perfected the technology, but I don't think they generally fell out of the sky. But you could be insured against it down there at Pettigo Rogers and Company in 1934. All right, 1944, Sam. What's the news? The Glasgow Times in the Evening Journal report that 10 Glasgow band members are going to play in a district concert. 10 members of the Scotty Band have been selected to play in the All-District Band, according to Charles Honeycutt, the band director. The All-District Band will give a concert at the 3rd District Education Association meeting Friday at Bowling Green. The band is composed of 100 pieces and consists of the best musicians from the 16 bands in the district. Now listen to these names. Selected for the All-District Band here in 1954, Prentha Alexander, Nancy Wyatt, Pat Ryan, Leila Ann Dickinson, David Adams, Jesse Ferguson, Billy Poteet, Billy Pruitt, H.B. Steen, and Curtis Wilson. The concert begins at 8:30 on Friday morning in Van Meter Hall. Last year's concert was actually given here, so they're going on the road this year. My goodness. There's locally famous musicians mentioned all throughout that story.
Certainly.
So you can see how our love of music was gets up to the competitive level there in 1954 with those big names.
Well, and Henry, let's go back. We skipped over 1944.
We did? Why did we do that anyway? Was it my fault? Yes, it was.
Well, sometimes it just happens.
That's right. I got to find it. You tell me. Oh, wait a minute. Here, I found it. 1944, we've got Mr. Sidney L. Bowles being buried with military honors. Mr. Bowles is 80, a Spanish-American War veteran. He died last Friday and, after a funeral service held at his residence, was buried Sunday in the Glasgow Cemetery with military honors by an escort of Spanish-American War comrades and the Lucas Firing Squad of Barren County Post-American Legion. Now, Mr. Bowles was born in Cumberland County, but he came to Glasgow with his parents when he was only 2 years old. Besides his devoted wife, he is survived by three sisters. 1944. Tell us about Mr. Sidney L. Bowles, Sam.
Well, a very, very fine family in Glasgow who contributed on all sorts of fronts in this community. One of his sisters, of course, was one of the founders of St. Helen Catholic Parish. Mm-hmm. And so certainly noteworthy.
Amazing how much history that this community has that we just don't even take the time to appreciate sometimes, you know?
Exactly.
And I'm glad you stopped me and said, that's an important one that we need to get in here. Let me get this in, too. I just came up here to 19 and 34, so we can kind of get back on track. There was a raid on the Cherry Roadhouse north of town. I just had to do one more roadhouse story here, Sam.
Yes.
In a raid on Cherry's Roadhouse north of town, officers confiscated 55 pints of liquor. Possession of liquor charges were preferred. Interesting. But they got a pretty good haul. 1964, let's look at the Glasgow Times to see about the Park City Homecoming Queen this year. It's Miss Sheila de Mundren. She was crowned by co-captains Ellis Dennison and Mike Bell. The crown bearers and the flower girl were, get this, Freddie and Francine Bull. Now, of course, that's a twin brother and sister in 1964. And, of course, their parents and grandparents were from Park City. So I'm sure they were a cute little couple there in 1964.
I bet they were as cute as
buttons. Going across the football field in Park City, Kentucky in 1964. They wouldn't have been very old either in 64. Let's look at 1974. We have the 50th wedding anniversary celebrated this month, including Mr. and Mrs. Walter Bunch, Mr. and Miss C.B. Melton, and Mr. and Miss Floyd Smith. Now, if memory is correct, isn't Mr. and Miss Bunch Gail Berry's parents?
That would be correct.
All right. Well, I didn't want to mess that up. But how's that? A wonderful celebration, the Golden Wedding Anniversary in 1974 of the Bunches and the Meltons and the Smiths. Okay, let's jump over here to 1984. Let me get in the Glasgow Times. We find out the lease of the boat dock at Barren River State Park has recently been purchased by Stanley Wilkinson and James Alexander. So some activity down there. We talk about the state park and the lake and the lodge and all that, but you got to have good boat docks. And two good gentlemen who were purchasing that one down there at the state park. Let's see. This is 1994, Sam. We read about the Glasgow Scotty soccer team playing one of their better games of the season against Warren Central here at Glasgow. The Scotties avenged an earlier 5-1 loss to Central by tying the Dragons 2-2. Soccer there in 94 were just kind of coming into play in our community.
It certainly was.
And the boys had really taken off. News in the Barren County Progress in 2004. The homecoming is coming up Friday night at Glasgow High School. They will be hosting Todd County Central. The Rebels coming to town here in 2004. And it was 2014 in the Barren County Progress. We read about the National 4-H Club Week celebrated. Melanie Watson is inducted into the Kentucky 4-H Hall of Fame. Now, that's a wonderful choice to go into the Hall of Fame for Miss Melanie Watson there in 2014. So there it is, Sam. We've had a week's worth of history into the archives. I appreciate all of your input into this as well. It's all of the archivists who do the digging, and certainly we appreciate you turning on the radio and joining us today here on WCLU.